Hello everyone. As you know that from this year, CBSE has introduced one more topic, that is informal letter. So what is informal letter? Informal letters are those letters which we are writing to our relatives and friends. It also includes letter of invitations, replies to invitations and reminders. Now I want to discuss the features of informal letter. First, informal letters must be personal in nature. As we are writing the letters to our friends or relatives, so these letters are very personal. Second, the language must be simple and clear also. Next, we have to use natural or lively way. We are not supposed to use artificial. We are not supposed to use formality there. As we are writing to our friends or relatives, so the language must be simple. We must write down in natural way. Next is express feelings. We have to use our feelings in these letters. We can also share our joys and sorrows in informal letter. If we are happy, then we can also share experience of happiness with our friends or relatives. If we have some problem, then we can also share our problems to our friends and relatives. Next is, we can also share our religious festival, our social events, our social facts also in informal letters. We can also make complaints in informal letter. We can also write down suggestions also. We can also give suggestion in informal letter to our friends or relatives. So these are some features of informal letter. Now I want to tell the marking scheme of informal letter. As you know that I have already discussed, it is of 10 marks. So 10 marks is further divided into three things. First is content. So content is of 4 marks. Content means the body part of the letter, that is 4 marks, which include at least 3 paragraphs in the contents. Second is expression. How you are express your views. In it, including grammar accuracy, appropriate words and spellings. Everything include in expression and it is of 4 marks. Next, relevance of ideas and styles. According to the topic, you have to give your ideas. You have to share your things. If you are not writing according to the topic, then your marks will be cut. So relevance must be there. According to the question, you have to share your things. Next, format. Format is of 2 marks. So what is the format of informal letter? That also I want to discuss here. As you know that format also include 2 marks. In format, how you had to write down the informal letter, how you had to give gapping also, how you had to write down, how you have to use the left alignment there, all those things included in format. First of all, address. Whether you are writing sender's address or receiver's address, that must be in 3 lines. If the address is given in the question paper, then you have to use the same address in your answer sheet also in your notebook. If there is no address given and you have to write down the address in your exam, then what you have to use, that is examination. Examination hall. Then you can write down A, B, C, CT and X, Y, Z. You're not supposed to use anything of your own. But if address is given, then you have to write down the address given in the question paper. Again, how you had to write down? Like, you can write down the house number first, then city, then your state or district you can write down. Yeah, it means address should be in 3 to 4 line, not in 2 line. Then you had to give 1 line blank. It is very compulsory. Wherever I show the arrow mark, it means you have to give 1 line blank. That is part of format. If you are not giving 1 line blank, again your format marks will be cut. And you know very well that format marks is of 2 marks. Then date. Many students are doing wrong writing of date. Like, you have to write down 5th April 2020 completely. Not like that 5th APR. Don't use the short form of the month name. You have to use the full name of the month. Then 2020. You can't write down like 5/4/20. No. You have to write down the month name completely. These things students are continuously doing wrong. So you have to take care of this. Next, salutation. In salutation, don't use this word salutation. It means salutation means what you have to include. That is, dear father, if you are writing to your relatives, then you can write down dear father, dear mother, dear uncle, etc. But if you are writing to your brother, sister or friend, then you have to write down the name. Like dear, the brother name you can write down like dear Sohan, dear Mohan, your dear Simran. But don't use the surname. Like, you can't write down dear Simran Balhara. You have to use only dear Simran, dear Mohit instead of dear Mohesh Sharma. Surnames need not to write down in the informal letter. Next, again you have to give 1 line blank. Then start the para number 1. Again, one more thing, you have to use the left alignment. You can't start anything, whether it is address, date, salutation or paragraphs, from the middle. All the things you have to start from the left side and from the same gap. In para 1, what are the things included? That is introduction. You have to introduce. Not you in introduction, what you can use? You can greet the family members, wish them. You can also ask about his or her family, or if they are working in any school or institution, you can also ask about the family, school or institute there. Then again, you have to leave 1 line blank. Then you have to start para 2. In that para also, the same process, you have to use the left side. Like, if your first para end here, then you can't start the second para from there. You have to give 1 line blank, and then from the left side only you have to start the para number 2. In this paragraph, you have to discuss your programs or the person para programs also. You can also discuss. It means in second paragraphs you have to give the details of the matter. Completely details you have to given in the second paragraph. If you are organizing any program, that program completely you have to discuss. If you are facing any problem, then you can write down your problems. If you want to give some suggestion, that suggestion also you can give in the second paragraph. Like, the complete details of the matter you have to give in second paragraph. Then again, you have to give 1 line blank. Then para 3. The third paragraph is your summing up of the paras or your letter, where you have to conclude. In this, when you are ending your letter, you have to give nice and warm closing statement. It is very necessary. Like, please give my regards to mother, father, or give my regards to uncle or aunt. You can also use, if you are writing to your brother, sister or friend, you can also write down, I am looking forward to seeing you. I am looking forward to hearing from you. I can't wait to see you soon. Like this, you have to give warm statement in the third paragraph and end your letter. Then leave one line blank. Then you have to give the subscription. Don't use this word subscription. In subscription, what you have to use, that is your sincerely. The main problem that students are doing continuously wrong, that is they are using apostrophe here. Don't use apostrophe in your words. And don't cut S also. Complete Y should be in capital. Then you have to write down Y-O-U-R-S without a apostrophe. Yours you have to write down. Then sincerely. Or you can also write down yours affectionately. Thanking you also. Or lots of love. Anything you can use. Then you have to write down the your name. This is the format of your letter. Now what you have to do? You have to write down the format of your letter, this informal letter, in your notebook. Then I will give you some questions of informal letter. Those questions you have to solve in your notebook. Thank you.